Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm Tammy Salamone, the Pink Survivor. Today I wanted to give you just a little standing ab and stretch workout. So I do have a pair of weights, but you probably will only need one weight today, or you could probably even do all of these without. Okay, first, let's just get started a little bit here with just a little marching to just kind of get your heart rate up just a little here, because I don't want you stretching too cold. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much. And yeah, I think this will be good. Let's do heel taps here, okay? Just heel taps. Oops. Just in case, you know, you haven't worked out yet, just take a minute or two here just to warm up, let you know what we're gonna do. Okay. Now you're gonna just step out to the side. Side. Okay. Perfect. How's everyone doing today? This is a nice video too to do maybe after one of the other workout videos. You can do this one to add just a little bit of abs and some stretching in. Now what you're gonna do are some butt kicks. So it's gonna be fun. Your heel is going to go back. So just kick it. Kick it. If you have a towel and a water if you need. Perfect. Let's do 3, 2, and 1. Give me a nice good deep breath here. Okay, so I'm gonna grab one of my weights here to get started. And what you're going to do is we're gonna do a little side bend. So the one weight is just gonna be down here on your side. Your other arm is going to either be here at your shoulder, or you can come up and over your head like this. Okay? So let's do some standing side bends first. And now I wanted to tell you, while you're doing this, don't just have your abs just doing nothing. Try and suck them in and keep your core strong and tight and in as you're doing this. So now you're focusing on your obliques, which is the side of your waist, and you're also working the front too. And it's gonna protect your back as well. So let's remember our abs and our core. Do a few more here. And switch, same thing on the other side. So remember, if you don't have weights, you could still be doing the same exact motion. You're going to go side to side and you're going to keep your core tight. And then you have right here or here, whatever feels most comfortable for you. Good. Do a little more on this side to pull it out. Let's do like 8 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. I am going to still stick with my one weight here, but if you have a water bottle or something instead, if you don't have any weights or no weights, that's fine too. This one's going to come overhead, okay, with my hands. Hopefully you can still see me. I'm going to keep my core tight here, and I'm going to try and just move over to the one side, center, other side. So, little bend here, trying to bend at your waist. Okay, so your core is doing all of this action and motion, and the power is coming from here. Up, other side, up. It doesn't take a lot of weight to feel this one too. Keep going. Let's do one more on each side. Good. Okay. Take a little break here while I show you what the next one's going to be. What you're going to do is you're going to try and hold your weight or just arms out in front here. and you're gonna come turn to the one side, center, and the other side. So kind of similar, but not overhead. This one's out in front. Do the best you can here to kind of use your core, keep the abs tight there. Center, other side, center. Side, center, side, center, side, center, good. Side, keep your core tight. Keep it going. Great. I know your arms are getting a little tired here. Other side, and center, good. Ooh, yeah, I know. And that kind of works your upper body and your abs as well. Let's see if there's anything else. Oh, we don't need to wait for this next one. We're gonna do this one, then we're gonna do some little stretching. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna try and have your hands behind your head, and then your knee is gonna try and come up towards your elbow, the same elbow, okay? So you got this, then we're gonna switch to this. So let's do like 10 on each side, ready? One, remember, keep that core tight. Two, and see how the knee is coming up. The elbow's not coming down. Three, four, five, just do the best you can. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Same thing other side, ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Great job, you guys. Let's do some stretching like I promised you. A little extra stretching. Okay, first, let's do a little side bend. So you're just gonna reach out to the side. Breathe and relax. Wipe the sweat if you need. Remember, this is your relaxing time now. And the other side. Good. Come up slowly. We're gonna do some shoulder rolls first. You're gonna roll them forward. Then you're gonna roll them back. Back always feels so good. Next, I want you to grab your hands in front, and then you're gonna turn your wrists and your hands and stretch it out. I love this forearm stretch. So you start here. Give it a turn and then reach it out. Still breathing. Next, you're gonna grab your hands behind you. So grab them behind you if you can. Then you're going to reach and stretch them out. And then it's gonna open up your chest and get a good chest stretch. Next, what we're gonna do is a shoulder stretch. So you're gonna try and have your hand here on your back, okay? Then you're gonna try and grab your hand and then just kind of gently pull it forward. This one's a little more difficult, but just move your hand a little forward if you can't reach it. But this one gets it's a good shoulder, and also a little bit in your upper back, you're gonna feel this too. And switch, so it's here. I'm gonna try and grab it here, and then just pull it a little forward. Keep your breathing. Good. Okay, next what you're going to do is, I'd like you to try and stand a little wider than normal. And what you're gonna do is just try and come down as far as you can. If you can go reach towards the ground, that would be great. Keep holding it. Now you can slowly come on up and stand pretty wide still. Lean over to one side, get a stretch for the inside of your leg. Foot can be down or the toe can be pointed up. Come up and do the same exact thing on the other side here. Good job. I feel that right there. Come on up. We're gonna do one of my favorite stretches, which is a quad stretch. This is the one if you need to hold on to something, you can. Just focus. Usually if you focus on one spot somewhere, that will help with your balance. Just grabbing your foot, getting a stretch in the front of the leg. Switch, same thing. Concentrate if you need to. Try and work on your balance. If you need to hold on, hold on, but then try and let go. Good. This time, you're gonna grab your knee or your ankle, wherever you can, then you're gonna kind of just rotate your ankle a little bit. Good. If you can, you can just stay here or you can try and stretch that out. You'll use your balance and you'll get another good stretch. Other side, grab it, rotate your ankle, remember. Stay there or stretch it out. Get another good hamstring stretch. Good. Okay, let's do a little neck stretch here. Let's come back up here. And let's do the one where we're trying to look behind you. So your arms can just be relaxed. You're gonna turn your head and try and look behind you. You can look down a little. You can look up. And switch, same thing other side. So first, you're just relaxing, you're trying to look behind you. You can look down, up. Good. Okay, let's get another good deep breath in here and get on with your day, okay? Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed that little standing ab and stretch routine. You can add it on to one of the others and have a great day, you guys. I'll see you guys next time. You're all pink survivors.